Hi guys, hope you're keeping well. I just wanted to share a quick video update with some testimonies from my recent mission trip to Mazatlan. As you know, I took a team from Wairamkona out to Mexico at the beginning of this year, and we were able to partner with the Wairam based out in Mazatlan and a number of the different ministries that they're a part of out there. And we were just able to see firsthand God move in powerful ways, in ways that brought healing emotionally, physically, of just seeing people being encountered by the love of God and just receiving the good news of who he is. And it just was such a beautiful, beautiful time. And so some of those testimonies I just wanted to share with you today. It's the first one was from our time at the Restorers Ministry. Now, the Restorers Ministry partners with one of the local rehab facilities, and we get to come alongside the men and women that live in there and just really shine the light of the world in there and just show them who Jesus is and just love on them where they're at and just show them that there's hope for the future, and that hope comes from Jesus. And I was asked to do a teaching, and as I was praying with the Lord as to what I was to share and what I was to teach on, I really felt him strongly say to teach about the woman at the well. And I think for many of them there, the same as I have felt in my life, you know, there's been choices that I made in the past where I just really felt guilt and shame about. And I shared part of my testimony as I did the teaching. And I shared about how the woman at the well, how she was a trailblazer and a pioneer, how she was the first one in her town to receive the good news and went on to evangelize to her whole town, how God took the broken parts of her past and created beauty from ashes and wrote her a new story. And I just wanted to show them that there's hope, that he is the hope and the glory. And so as I was sharing my testimony and sharing the story, I could just see them really believing that there's more, and believing that there's hope, that there's hope for a second chance, that, you know, God's not done with them yet. And so I also felt, as I was praying about the teaching, that I was to wash their feet afterwards. And I could tell they were a little bit reluctant at first. And in particular, there was one girl there who was 14 years old, and she really seemed quite closed off and quite guarded. And as I was praying and prophesying and washing the feet of the other women, I could feel that the walls were starting to come down a little bit, and she allowed me to wash her feet. And in fact, as I went to leave the rehab facility that day, she actually hugged me, and I just really felt how much God loved her. I just felt how much she encountered the Father heart of God and how much he loves her. And she just felt that in herself, and just to see her be encountered by that grace and by that love, it just was so beautiful and so moving. And I just know and pray that for each and every one of those women that are in the rehab facility, that each and every day they start to take hold of who God created them to be. Another testimony that we had from our time when we were in Mazatlan was partnering with Biblias Para Mexico, who distribute Bibles around Mexico, and the aim of the organization is to get a Bible in every house in Mexico. And at the moment, there's about 80 to 85% of the homes in Mazatlan that have a Bible. Well, we partnered with them, and one day we went out to one of the colonias, the shanty areas out there, and we met a lady called Anna, and we were praying with her, and we gave her a Bible. And as we were praying for her, she broke down, and I was with a couple of the guys from our team. And we just felt an urgency to just ask her what was going on. And she basically had said that her home had been broken into a couple of weeks beforehand. She lived about three blocks away and was staying with her son because she was so traumatised. She hadn't set foot back in the house since it had happened. In fact, she had to hide her daughter under the bed because if the men who robbed them had found their daughter, they would have damaged her and they would have really badly hurt her. And so they hid her under the bed. And so they were really, really traumatised and frightened from that. And we just felt that we were to go and cleanse and anoint the house. So we asked their permission to do that. And they came with us. And as we entered in that house, we just felt those chains being broken off, those chains of fear, the trauma. And we just felt the joy of the Lord just re-enter that home. And we just felt a manifest presence of the Holy Spirit just encounter Anna and her daughter Maria. And we just saw that peace just come upon them. And it was just such a powerful moment of seeing God move and seeing him healing and bringing restoration to that family, what the enemy intended for harm that God was using for his glory. And we just saw just such a change in the atmosphere, even from entering the house to leaving. And it was just so powerful. So guys, that's just a couple of the testimonies that I wanted to share with you quickly. And I'll do another video update soon just to let you know what's going on in the season and how you can partner with me in prayer. Love to you all. Take care. Speak to you soon. Bye.